Hello students, today we are going to learn a new chapter, that is chapter 3, pronoun. Pronoun. What is a pronoun? A pronoun is a word which is used instead of a noun. What is a pronoun? Pronoun is a word which is used instead of a noun. In short, we can say that a pronoun is used instead of a noun to avoid repetition of a noun in an essay or in any other sentence. For example, she, they, it, her, him, etc. And what is an antecedent? The noun that a pronoun replaces is known as its antecedent. I will repeat once again. The noun that a pronoun replaces is known as its antecedent. Now, look at the different types of pronouns. How many types of pronouns are there? There are 8 types of pronouns. That are personal pronoun, possessive pronoun, demonstrative pronoun, interrogative pronoun, reflexive pronoun, relative pronoun, distributive pronoun, and indefinite pronoun. And in the first one, personal pronoun, there are 2 types of personal pronouns are there. That are subjective pronoun and objective pronoun. I will be explaining each of them in details. Today, we take up the personal pronoun and possessive pronoun. So let us look at what is personal pronoun. A personal pronoun refers a specific person or object or group of things directly. Now let us look at the textbook. Personal pronouns such as I, you, she, he, him, her, them, it stands for and replace persons or thing. There are 2 types of personal pronouns. We have already said it. The first one is subjective, that is the one that play the role of a subject instance. In short, we can say used for subjects. For example, I, we, he, she. The second one is objective. That is the one that play the role of an object of a preposition or a verb used for objects. For example, me, us, him, her. A personal pronoun describes a person or a thing in the following way. The first person. What is the first person? The person who speaks. What is the first person? The persons who speaks. For example, I, we, us. And second person. What is the second person? The person who is spoken. What is the second person? The second person who is spoken. Example, you. And the third person. What is the third person? A person or thing which is spoken about. A person or a thing which is spoken about. Example, she, he, they, it, etc. For example, she is an intelligent teacher. They were going to market. He brought some nice books. Now, let us look at the table. Different forms of personal pronouns are given here. In the table, it is very clear that first person singular I is subjective and me is objective. Whereas first person plural we is subjective and us is objective. In the second person singular and plural, whether it is subjective or objective, it is always you. There is no change here. In third person singular, we have he and she as objective. And their objective will be him or her. For both of them, third person plural would be they as subjective and them as objective. And third person singular, it remains the same in subjective and objective. There is no plural for it. Now, let us talk about possessive pronouns. What is possessive pronouns? Pronouns that shows possession or belonging are called possessive pronouns. Pronouns that shows possession or belonging are called possessive pronouns. For example, his, yours, his, mine, ours. In English, there are two simple ways in which we can show possession or belonging. First one, by using apostrophe S with a noun. The second one, by using a possessive pronoun. Let us read the sentences. Bijit is a friend of mine. Sayanandan and Nupur are my cousins. We come to school together by car. The car is theirs. In these sentences, pronouns such as mine and theirs show possessions. Possessions or belonging. Belonging or ownership. Mine refers to the relationship of Bijit as a friend with reference to the speaker. This shows a status of the car belonging to both Satyanandan and Nipur. Now, let us look at the table, which shows you the different forms of possessive pronouns. Now, first person singular is mine and plural is ours. The second person singular and plural is yours. And third person his and hers, and its plural would be theirs. Now your homework is, let us take the page number 21. Do the given exercises in your textbook. Thank you.